They're worth billions of dollars to the national economy, and businesses in the CBD also have the power to choose Sydney's next council. Like residents, they can vote at local government elections. But as Lachlan Kennedy discovered today, no one seems to know.
More than a million people live, work and visit the CBD each day, yet last time its influential local council was elected, just 62,000 people voted, and 98% of them were residents.
That effectively the voice of business doesn't count.
20,000 commercial ratepayers have the right to vote in local elections and have a say on everything from bike lanes to parking, but it's almost a well-kept secret.
I've been a business owner in the City of Sydney for 27 years. I've never known I could vote.
Angela Vithoukas is an award-winning cafe owner. She's now running for mayor and drumming up support from other retailers.
I've yet to talk to a business owner who knew they could vote.
There is another very simple reason why businesses are being urged to vote in 2 months' time, and that's because this local government area is responsible for nearly 8% of the nation's GDP.
But as the city's worth swelled to $19 billion, fewer businesses took up their democratic right. At the turn of the century, just under 5,000 operators lodged a vote. That number more than halved in 2004, and 4 years later, it plummeted. A hefty amount of paperwork could be to blame.
Business is required to re-enrol for each local government election, so the roll doesn't carry forward.
That's now being investigated by a specialist panel.
Our review is an all cards on the table exercise, as the minister keeps saying.
Businesses have until Monday night to enrol. Lachlan Kennedy, 10 News.